Hi guys, today I want to talk about importing DWG into a business center. So what's a DWG? DWG is a file developed by Autodesk for AutoCAD. Basically, the Wikipedia says it's a binary file format using for storing two or three dimensional design data and metadata. It's proprietary to Autodesk and it's just a CAD file. So let's open a new default project. I do have a DWG file on my desktop somewhere. Oh, there it is, right here. Let me move it on the side so we can nicely work with it. So Business Center has a native importer, so it's as easy as dragging and dropping it into plan view. Business Center will read it, and obviously it's gonna tell you there is 1302 errors and zero warnings. You can hit yes to view the summary. Honestly, it's been a while. I do not go through this because it just, most of the files are, you see, like what is this one, some flags because it's set to zero and it's not making sense to be zero. So wow, you know, again, layer zero already exists because I already had that in my business center. This is basically it. However, I want to show you one more trick here. And this is, if I right click this file, and as you can see, the DWG file, it's about 3.95 megabytes, so about 4 megabytes here, right? Leave that open, and I'm gonna go to my data prep ribbon, and there is something called the project cleanup. Beautiful, beautiful tool, very helpful. As you can see, by running this, scan all the data, all the entities in your business center file and apply to them these cleanup functions. Remove unused block definition, remove unused line styles, remove unused text styles, remove unused dimension styles, remove zero length and fragment line. So you can define how much, right? I have it at 5 millimeters. Remove duplicate lines, remove overlapping line loops, remove unprotected layers with no object, join lines. Again, you can define your gap, remove blank text objects, remove hatch objects, filter line vertices, including CAD splines. Again, you can define how much. I like it to be around 5 millimeters. And now minimum and maximum elevation, and if it's out of that elevation, just assign it a zero. I don't like to have the check mark on the remove unused textiles because I do have some predefined textiles which are empty. For example, I have one textile for my CAD fill maps. And also remove unprotected layers with no objects. If you have certain layers preset in your template and you have not protected your layers, it would erase them. So let's see, I'm gonna apply this to entire project, and I'm gonna hit apply. And well, depending on the speed of your computer, 236 unused blocks definitions were removed, 91 unused line styles were removed, 12 unused dimension styles, 2 zero length lines, 12 duplicate lines, there was no overlapping line loops, no blank text object, hatched objects there were 45, filtered 106 of total 4100 vertices, no elevation change, and it did join 826 lines. So if you look at your project, nothing has changed. However, it had removed so much stuff out of it. I go to export and export the DWG file. So I have exported the DWG without changing any settings. So let's compare them side by side. Look at this. On the right hand side, I have the original file, which is about 4 megabytes. On the left hand side, I have 400 kilobytes. By only running one command and getting rid of all the unnecessary stuff in the DWG file, we were able to shrink it significantly. So if anything else, you should always run your CAD files through the Business Center and do this cleanup, because it's so much worth it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hit like, subscribe, and comment. We'll see you next time.